Good day and welcome back to Pebble Opinion. I'm Pebble O. Thank you so much for tuning in. If it's your first time, welcome. And if it's not, then welcome back. So today I'm going to be doing some of Africa's top female artists. And yesterday I did Yemi Alade from Nigeria and I did Joni and I enjoyed that reaction so much. If you haven't watched it, make sure to check it out. And today I'm going to be staying right here in South Africa and I'm going to be doing Khumalo. The very controversial, the very talented, the very beautiful Khumalo. And I'm going to be doing a song, Asine. Now, that's another very controversial song. It's very controversial, but it's very nice. You know, I love that song so much. But it's got a lot of, you know, controversy behind it. We all know that because of the sins of death, Katie has been linked to that, as well as Chico Twala. And then surprisingly or ironically, this song, Asine, was written by Chico Twala, you know, and he wrote it for Khumalo apparently. But we'll get more into the story as, you know, we go through the song. So let's get into the song. This is Africa's top female artist, and today, like I said, we're featuring Khumalo, and this is Asine. Let's check it out. It means that it's not me who killed Khuzwayo, and I had to translate, I had to Google the lyrics because I don't understand the language. And yeah, man, it says that she's sitting in jail being accused of something she didn't do. She's being accused of murder, and she's saying that Asine, Asine way, meaning it's not me who killed Khuzwayo, it's not me who killed Papa. And then on the song, it seems like she's talking to her mother and pleading to her mother to believe her when she says that she's not the one responsible for what she's being accused of. And now when you look at the Senzo story, you know, it seems like, and the funny thing is, this song dropped before Senzo got, you know, killed. So it's crazy, you know, that Chico wrote this song for her, but apparently Chico wrote the song for he tested the song on Yvonne Chaka Chaka and then Khumalo, and then he decided to go with Kelly instead of Yvonne Chaka Chaka, you know. So it could have been done by Yvonne Chaka Chaka, but he chose to go with Khumalo. And then later on, they're being accused of somehow being involved in the Senzo murder. I'm not saying anything about, I'm not accusing anybody of anything. I'm just saying that it's, you know, ironic, and the conspiracy theorist in me is obviously going to look further into it. But you know what? Today is about the song. It's not about the case. I'm not a judge. I'm not a lawyer. I'm not any of those things. All I know is music, and I love Kelly Kumalo's music. I think she's very talented. So today we're going to be focusing on the song. But hey, there's a lot of controversy behind the song, and I couldn't just go on without, you know, touching on that. But let's get back into the music.
Yes.
mean, if you're going to accuse somebody of something, and then you listen to them singing this song, I'm sure you're just like, okay, guys, maybe she didn't do it because, you know, the way that she sounds on this song, it sounds so genuine. And like I say, it's crazy that this song dropped before Senzo got killed. Because I remember, I think a few weeks before Senzo got murdered, there was a video of him and Kaylee in a car and Senzo was driving, I think, and they were singing this song together, you know. It's so crazy, you know. You wonder, how is it a prophecy? Is it just a coincidence? You know, me, I don't believe in coincidences, but that's just me, you know. And like I said, I'm not accusing anybody of anything. I'm just saying. So calm down. I'm a fan of Kelly Khumalo's music, you know, and I don't believe in this thing of canceling people just because they're being accused of something, you know, because if you're gonna cancel people based on the wrong things that they do, then you're gonna end up with no music on your phone. You're not gonna listen to any artist, because a lot of artists get up to a lot of things that we don't know about, you know. Just because you see somebody on stage and you like their music, it doesn't mean that they're angels, you know. So this thing of canceling people just because they're accused of this or that, like this thing that's been happening with Lady Zama and Sjava. Me, I still listen to both their music, you know, because I'm just like, you know what, I don't know what you did, but me, I love your music and it connected to me somehow. So I'll just focus on that because I don't know anything else. All I know is music. So let me get back into the music. How hot and how beautiful Kelly Khumalo is. I think she's got like 2 or 3 kids now, but she looks like this. Imagine, guys. Let's just talk about that for a second. Let me just be vain just for a second and appreciate Kelly Khumalo for looking like this after dropping 2 or 3 babies. I'm not sure, but yeah, man. Of that reaction, you know, that was a beautiful song written by Chico Twala for Kelly Khumalo, and she delivered, of course, she killed it, you know. And that song is Asime, a very controversial song, like I said, but you know, nonetheless, it's a great song by a great artist and a great writer. And that's how we come to the end of that. That was Africa's top female artist, and today we featured Kelly Khumalo. But that's how we come to the end of that reaction. Please subscribe if you like what I do here on Pebble Opinion, and like if you do like what I do. But for now though, I'm out and I'll be seeing you next time.